Micha Reuven, Ben Yirmiyahu v'Zehava, Bachur HaBar Mitzvah, Revi'it Chazak.
V'nizkehem chasi hahin ye lapar, ushlishit hahin la'ayil, revi'it hahin la'keves yayin, zot olat chodesh bechodesho lechodeshei hashana.
Just so filled with gratitude. And I'm very cognizant of everything that's going on in the world around us, and we have the opportunity to celebrate a mensch of just unparalleled stature, Micah, as he has this beautiful day. What an honor for us to be the ones representing so many others that would love to be here.
The story of your life is not yet written, but you have done a great job developing your protagonist. And we know an engaging main character is what drives every great story. You have a good character, a deep neshama. Your pure soul shines through everything you do, drawing people toward you as they invest in your success, as you invest in theirs. You take a challenge and turn it into a strength, but it's not magic. It's determination, perseverance, and courage.
Micah, you are a blessing to us. Watching you navigate the world, both its good and its bad, while keeping your independent and loving spirit intact, is a blessing. Watching the depth of your resilient soul is a guide to us grown-ups, your parents, on how we can be better people. You are blazing a path of your authentic self.
You are an open heart, a dream working to be realized, a positive force in a world that desperately needs you. Go forth and write your next chapter.
It says, Higid lecha adam matov uma aronai doresh mimcha ki ima sot mishpat vavar chesed vatznei alechet im Elohecha. People, God has told you what is good and what God requires of you, only to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk modestly or humbly with your God. Micah, you are somehow the 13-year-old embodiment of what Micah says that God is asking each one of us to do. Your commitment to justice and fairness for people that you know and for people that you'll never meet is obvious. The volunteer work that you and your family do aims to fix the imbalances in the world around us. Your drash underscores how you think about justice and what an important role that it plays in your life.
If the Hebrew calendar is not our main calendar, why do we keep it around? Why should we use it at all? How is the Hebrew calendar relevant or meaningful to our lives? We use calendars to plan and mark events in our lives. The lesson of the Hebrew calendar is that we must schedule times to work toward justice. The moral universe will only bend toward justice if people push and resist and fight. Justice can only come if people are first willing to testify honestly about the brokenness they see around them. It is the truth-telling, says Brian Stevenson, that will pave the path forward toward a better world.
You know, this isn't a charge for you to change. It's a blessing and hope and charge for you to continue. And when you realize, this is my time to shine, this is my time when the world needs me, and I'm going to step forward blazing like the sun, and here I am.
Again. I've tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way. I kept on falling short of something. I could have gave up then, but then again I couldn't have, 'cause I've traveled all this way for something. I take it in, but don't look down. 'Cause I'm on top of the world, hey.
I'm so excited this day is finally here. I would like to thank everyone who came and who's here, because you guys all mean so much to me and I could not have done this without you. And I would like to thank everyone who helped me lead, and I would like to thank all my family members who helped me, and just everyone, because you guys all made me who I am today. Thank you.